Hi and welcome to this introduction course for Revit massing. Have you ever seen buildings like these and wondered what tool could I use in Revit to model such beautiful buildings? Normally these buildings are not created in the basic project environment. Such buildings are created in a different environment called massing. And massing in Revit is our subject for today. Let's go to Revit. You can simply go to Revit menu, click New, Family, and navigate to Conceptual Mass, select the Mass Template, click Open. This is how you start a massing environment. If you're using a different version, like Autodesk Revit 2020, you select Families, New, Conceptual Mass, Metric Mass. When you're inside this environment, you'll see that you don't have the tools you might be familiar with. You have three tools instead: Model, Reference, and Plane. And all of these tools are creating lines or shapes. In the drawing environment, you will see that we have a level in 3D. We also have two reference planes intersecting in the middle that are vertical to your level. If you want to activate any of them, all you have to do is just select it. How do I keep track of which level is activated? You simply go to Work Plan, click Show, and this will show you which level is activated right now. If I select this vertical plane, you'll see that it's automatically highlighted. So I'll start from this point. I'll show you now how to use the basic tools of massing. Let's start with a basic rectangle. If I create a rectangle like that, and then I press Escape or Modify, go back and select it. Now you'll see that we have a Modify panel that you can actually use to create forms out of this shape. Click the Create Form tool, Solid Form, and you will see immediately that it creates an extrusion out of this rectangle. You can modify this extrusion freely by pressing one of these arrows. You can also skew it in one of these directions, X or Y. You might also want to create a void form. I'm going to select that new shape, and now I will choose Void Form. This creates a void form that is automatically subtracted from that model. Now we've created a subtraction. There are mainly five main tools that we use in Revit for modeling. So for modeling geometries, you can either use Extrude, Sweep, Blend, Swept Blend, or Revolve. Let me show you these one by one. Now to create a blend, I need two levels. A blend is a blend between two shapes, two different shapes in different levels or different heights. So I'm going to switch to Create menu and select the datum level. Now I'll create my level, let's say at 50,000 millimeters. On the first level, I'll create a rectangle. On the second level, by selecting it, I'll create a different rectangle. Now if you select these together by pressing Control, you can select both. And then click Create Form, that creates a blend between these two shapes. Even if you create, the third option is going to be Sweep. And to create a sweep, I'm going to create a path first. By pressing multiple points using the SP Line Through Points tool, I can create my path for the sweep. Now the next step is going to be selecting one of these points as a reference plane, then drafting our section or profile on that plane. So I'll go back to Set Work Plane, click one of these dots, and then start creating my profile, assuming that my profile is tapered shape. Now I can go back and select my path, press Control and select the section, click Create Form, and that's it. Now you have a sweep. Similar to a sweep, there is an option to create a swept blend. I'll go back and do the same steps as we've done with the first sweep. After creating the first section, I'll go back and set my work plane again to the other point. And from there, I'm going to create a different shape. Now I'm going to select each one of these. Now I'm going to select all of them by pressing Control to select and then create form. And you end up with a different result. For the last tool that we're going to use, I'm going to use a reference plane that is vertical. I'll create a section first, then I will create on the same plane a vertical line that will work as my revolve axis. Select both, pressing Ctrl key, create form, and now we have a revolve. I'm going to skip to the next step. Let's first delete all these shapes. Start on a clean sheet. Now the example I wanted to show you is this particular tower. This particular tower is interesting to me because it has a different section that transforms, creating such an interesting geometry. Let's see how we're going to achieve this geometry. In the top view, I'm going to create a rectangle. I will assume a dimension of 20 by 20. I'll move my shape in center. Then using the line tool, I will create small chamfers. I'll use the mirror tool to mirror them. Then use the trim tool, trim the corner, to finish that shape. Now to copy this in 3D to a higher level, I'm going to switch to one of my elevations. Select that shape. Select copy. Then if you want to copy it right now, it shows you that you can only copy it into this level. But if you uncheck constrain, then you're free to copy it wherever you like. I'm going to copy it to a height of 30. Then going back to 3D, I'll choose that newly created profile, rotate it by 45 degrees. Now my two shapes are in place. I'll go back to my elevation and repeat the same steps. Now if I select two of these shapes, click create form, you'll see a normal blend that we've seen before. Let me undo that and try selecting all of them together. By selecting all of these shapes, Revit automatically recognizes that you want to create a blend between all of them. And that's it. The concept is done within 5 minutes. If I select the top shape, I can also rescale it to have a different shape. I hope you've liked this introduction, and I hope you'll come back for more lessons from RevitCourses.com.